Gallimera, good morning, good morning. And I am now streaming live using Restream and going through my YouTube channel. I've also connected to my other channels as well, obviously Facebook, Twitch, and also onto Twitter as well. So I'm hoping that this broadcast is going out. I've got no idea if anybody's tuning in at the moment, but just to let you know, as you saw on Facebook, I just started to do the broadcast this morning, and then all of a sudden, for whatever reason, they decided to block my broadcast. I had to tinker about literally to re-get into my account, because I'm jumping between my laptop, my tablet, my phone, and then I have a second laptop as well. Backup one and broadcast one, and yeah, it's just got very complicated this morning. So once again, I apologize for the late online, but I don't know what's going on. I'm hoping that this broadcast is getting out. I know it will definitely probably be going up to YouTube anyway, so that means I won't have to reload to YouTube like I normally do. The only thing is, at the moment, I can't actually see any of your comments or anything else like that on my page at the moment, obviously, because obviously this is going out live. So once again, thank you to those people who had been dropping me comments. I'm just going to quickly refresh what I can see of my broadcast at the moment, and see if anything has appeared on there. I'm just refreshing that, just to let you know that the internet over here at the moment is absolutely shocking at the best of times. So I'm looking now. No, nothing has been changed on my page, on my Facebook at least anyway. Right, let's just have a quick look at the news, then let's just crack on with it, give you the stories of the day. First of all, can I just say thank you to all those people yesterday who were tuning in when I was doing my stream. Yes, I wasn't actually streaming yesterday. I was just recording my dance anthem shows for beatradio.co.uk for next week. Really nice. My first little stream I put out just before I started was, we weren't that particularly busy. However, as we went on, we got busier and busier. Mainly the front area where mixed people can go was really, really busy down there. Unfortunately, our vaxxed area, obviously, restrictions are in place there, and we weren't overly busy in the vaxxed area. So one thing is, you're always assured a seat in the vaxxed area. And thank you to all those people that tuned in. Weather forecast for today from the lovely Amanda. Temperatures 33 degrees, going to feel like 35. Again, fire warnings are still in place at the moment across all over. So once again, please be very careful when you're out and about. Jane at the moment, busy day for her. She's at the airport. And when it comes to flights at the moment at the airport, I'm just going to give you the UK flights. We've got 10 flights in. We should have had 11, but I'll go through that anyway. So first of all, we've got the Birmingham flight coming in at 11:30, a Leeds flight at 11:50. Then there's a TUI flight from Manchester. That's due in at 12:20. We then got another Birmingham flight that's due in at 1 o'clock. We've also got an EasyJet flight from London that's due in at 2. We've then got another Jet 2 flight that was that's scheduled for 6:50 tonight. We've also have another Thompson flight, or TUI flight, that's from Bournemouth, of all places. That's for 6:55. There's another British Airways flight from London at 7:55. Then there's another TUI flight from London Gatwick at 8:15. And there's also a Jet 2 flight from Manchester at 8:40. And there was also a Bristol flight with TUI that was scheduled. But looking at the information I've got, it's now said that that Bristol flight has been cancelled. Anyway, as for the COVID stats within the last 24 hours, it is starting to decrease a little bit. I'm just scrolling down now. We had 2,854 new infections yesterday. Sorry, the day before on my last report. Today's new infections is now at 2,472. So it's a slight drop. 13 new cases were detected at entries into the country. That was actually up on the day before where we had 11. Now, when it comes to stats in individual islands, Mykonos has reported 20 new cases. Rhodes, as Steve Kimberley asked me to keep an eye on that, he's now there at the moment. They've reported 51 new cases in Rhodes. Lefkada's had 14 new cases, which for a little island like that is a bit of an eyebrow raiser. Corfu has had 20 new cases. Prefecture of Kefalonia, they've had 3 new cases reported. And as for Zakynthos, I'm afraid again, we've had 18 new cases. That brings our total for the year up to 660 positive cases on the island. And for this month alone, that's 158 new cases that we've had on the island. And when you consider in June, we only had 7, it is raising eyebrows. Once again, just to remind you that Zakynthos is now in the orange, which is a high alert state than what we were before in amber. And I'm talking about the Greek alert state at the moment. So again, it's not boding well in that direction for us. Anyway, when it comes to deaths at the moment, deaths at the moment are actually slightly up as well. We had 7 new deaths yesterday. Today I can report 8 new deaths, bringing the death toll now to 12,890. 96% of them had underlying conditions or health problems or were over the age of 70. And once again, our condolences to those families that are affected. When it comes to critical cases, they're also on the rise as well. Did say 126 on my last report, and now we are at 133 new cases. 80 of those are male, and 53 of those are female. Right, now today's news then. Some good news as far as I'm concerned at the moment. The government, the Greek government, has no plans to ban vaccinated citizens, unvaccinated citizens from entering retail stores, according to the Deputy Interior Minister, Stelios Petsas. Now, in terms of retail, even with the lower vaccination rates, the use of health protocols and masks has prevented the virus from spreading. Therefore, at the moment, there is no discussion, he said, about retail, but mainly about travel and entertainment. Now, he was talking on Sky TV yesterday, referring to the restrictions at indoor venues like cinemas and restaurants. He said, we will clearly have a greater ease of movement for the vaccinated than for the unvaccinated, who may have to increasingly stay outside as we head to the autumn, Petsas said. So basically what they're saying is this: you can't stop people going into shops, whether you're vaccinated or unvaccinated, because people still have to eat. Okay, people still have to buy food so they can go on living. So what they're saying in effect is, we're not going to ban you unvaccinated people to go about and get food so you can eat. So we're not going to starve you, basically. However, we're not going to entertain you, and we're not going to let you go into restaurants and enjoy yourself in there. So that's basically what's on the table at the moment is, yeah, you'll be allowed grudgingly to go and shop for food. But when it comes to entertainment and it comes to basically the little nicer things in life, like going out for a meal, being unvaccinated, you are effectively going to be barred from doing that. Also, some interesting news yesterday in regards to TUI. TUI launched flights and packages to Kefalonia yesterday. It announced all its updates to their program for people wanting to go on holiday over to Kefalonia, which were supposed to start today. However, as part of the announcement, they also let drop that from Sunday the 25th of July until August the 31st, they have stopped all flights to Kefalonia with TUI. TUI obviously, following government updates, which take place every 3 weeks, has adjusted its schedule. It is recalled how TUI started flights and packages from July the 23rd in Skiathos and from the 27th in Hania. Now, travel to Halkidiki, Pressava, Samos, Santorini, Bassos, they're also going to remain closed until the 31st of July. So again, the reason Zakynthos has probably still got flights is because we are technically a much more flexible place to do business than some of the smaller islands because we have a lot more to offer. Even though our epidemiology in some ways probably is looking probably better, not as good as Kefalonia's might be. And when you consider last year, Kefalonia had no restrictions placed on them at all. Business just went on as normal, whereas we were restricted basically because of Laganas and because of the Mykonos effect is the best way to describe it. And then we obviously went into serious restrictions and measures, etc. So this year, it looks like TUI are looking to the islands with the more flexibility, the more to offer their fewer customers, so they capture all sides of the market. And I think Kefalonia has become the victim of that. Also here on the island, there was a car crash reported yesterday involving six people in two vehicles, which collided on the main Laganas Road. Now, it's unclear what the circumstances were of the crash, but it was a white Hyundai 120 that had five Italian tourists in it, and that collided with a grey Suzuki, which was being driven at the time by a Slovenian. Now, the Hyundai actually ended up on its roof, and the photographs that they actually showed in the local press were pretty pretty eye-raising, to say the least. However, no information has been given as regards to what happened about the occupants, as to what their state of injuries were or anything else like that. However, the accident is now being investigated by the traffic police here on Zakynthos. Also, interestingly, talking about the internet, it seems that all services of the Municipality of Thessaloniki were closed on Friday due to a cyber attack launched by hackers on Thursday. Now, according to the Deputy Mayor of Business Planning and E-Government and Migration Policy, Giras Avalas, the municipality closed all its services and web applications so that a proper investigation could be carried out in order to minimize the risk happening again. Now, speaking to local radio, Avalas said that it was a malicious virus that had been installed, with hackers asking for a ransom to obviously unlock files. We want to be fully assured that everything will work properly, he said, clarifying that all of the municipal's files, municipality's files, are being secured. Again, the internet, as I say, at the moment is a mystery to what is going on. Everything seems to be, whether it's hackers or not, or just the authorities trying to limit spread of information, it is really frustrating and very, very annoying. Anyway, a little bit of a sad tale here in Zakynthos again. The crew of the World Wildlife Blue Panda vessel, which is currently located here in Zakynthos, unfortunately found a dead turtle outside of the port. I think the port they're talking about is the Zakynthos port in town. Anyway, at first estimate, the turtle had been dead for about 3 days, they said. It had been hit by a propeller from a vessel. In fact, people who work at the port said it could be the turtle that is often seen appearing and swimming in the harbour. Anyway, please, please, if you rent boats or vessels, please be very careful that you keep a lookout. Please, again, if you see turtles in the water, do not chase them, do not harass them, and also obey the speed limits that have been set in the National Marine Park and other various areas in regards to the safety of boats. And once again, be aware, not only turtles are swimming about in the water, but there are people as well, And again, we've had two drownings already this year in the Zakynthos National Marine Park through people in the water. So please, please, please just be very careful. And once again, it is sad. Irresponsible people could have led to the death of that beautiful creature who, trust me, has had a hard life getting as far as it did. And looking at the size of the turtle, I would say that he wasn't very old, obviously, when he was obviously killed by a passing boat. Anyway, and finally, the ongoing saga of the Foskalos cinema. It seems that this is finally now or should I say the next chapter is now rolling on. For those people who are not quite sure what I'm talking about, there's been an investigation by the Zakynthos mayor into the contract that Stigma Radios had for the running of the local cinema here in Foskalos, which is the big, like, spiritual centre, as they call it, or a cultural centre here on the island. Now, to be honest, Stigma, I think, have been doing a fantastic job. Cinema is something that we desperately need on the island. However, it seems that the deal that they got at the time through a former mayor, Mr. Bazikis, basically liberties as far were being taken in regards what was expected to be paid to the municipality. A thorough investigation was carried out by the current mayor, Mr. Arakakis. I'm not going to go into the full list because it's a very long and drawn out and rather complicated list, lots of legalese. But the effect is this: the municipality now is going to file a lawsuit against Stigma, seeking compensation for the non-payment of rents and for non-payment of monies due from the snack bar that they were running, and also the legalities of that as well, which they say was in contravention to a very, very poor written contract between the former mayor. Basically, I think in his words, you've taken it the urine long enough. We need to put some money back into the municipality, and hopefully an agreement is going to come that it's not going to destroy the cinema, which is something that we desperately need to keep running. I can only give praise for the way the cinema has been run and what it's brought to the island in the realms of community spirit. But like everything else, things have to be paid for. You can't get things for free all the time. And again, if they've been a bit clever, shall we say, in their accounting, I think those days have to stop. And shall we say, a fresh board is then written underneath. It's very clear where they stand in regards payment of rents and rents charged. Also area of square footage in regards tables and chairs outside, and that there is a clear line being written, because it's to the benefit of us that the community, the cinema stays, and we have that option, because again, cinema is under such a threat after the, with the lockdown and everything else. We want to keep those nice things going that we do really appreciate in the winter. And even in the summer, there's nothing like the outdoor cinema in the summer, going watching a movie under the stars, and we'd like that to keep going. So anyway, we'll see how that proceeds, how that actually carries on, and we'll see how that works out. Right, I know there are people tuning in and watching the podcast. I'm still investigating as to why I've just suddenly, all of a sudden, been blocked. And I'm hoping maybe that you are seeing this. And if not, I will put a link in on my Facebook account to this podcast. Once again, it means now I don't have to put my podcast up to some of the broadcasting areas, because obviously it's going out now. So that has saved me a little bit of a job in some ways. But anyway, thanks again for your support. Again, I'll keep my ear to the ground. And if I hear of anything, I'll let you know. Ta-ra.